Today I'm going to show you an amazing number, and some of you may have come across this before. It's an absolute classic, but I still think there's a lot to be said about the number 9609393 4 9. This is where it gets quite interesting, actually, because it goes 9823809 6. You'll notice, actually, this is one of the more boring parts of the number 760. Every time I mess this bit up, hang on, that bit shouldn't be there. I put that in by accident. Sorry. Where was I? 4719. And there it is. That's the number I'm going to talk about today. I still find this number absolutely fascinating. And the reason this number is so great is because it relates to a fantastic inequality, a formula, if you will, which I will put underneath here. So the formula we're going to look at is a half less than the floor function of the mod function of the floor function of the y-coordinate on 17, floor function, times 2 to the power of negative 17 times the floor function of x, subtract the mod of the floor function of y again. Oh, that's floor, sorry. And that is mod 17, so I close that mod there. And then this whole thing, once you got that, you then, that open mod is 2, close that, and then close the floor function. Okay, so now we have ridiculous number and we have ridiculous equation. To show you how the two are linked, I thought I would show you the plot of this inequality. Because what they're saying is, if you have an xy axis, and you put, for each point on that plane, you put in the x and y coordinates into this formula, it will tell you whether or not you should color in that point. So in fact, this tells you which part of an xy plot should have a dot and which shouldn't. And I've got a printout I have done of that formula. And so if you plot that formula, you get this plot here. So this is the plot of that formula. And in case you're wondering what is particularly astounding about this, the formula, when you plot it, is itself. It is its own form. The formula is its own plot. The plot is the formula. This is called Tupper's self-referential formula. And when you plot it, you get itself. And that, for me, is one of the freakiest, most bizarre parts of mathematics. A formula which is its own plot. Okay, there is, however, one slight cheat. It actually does that. If you plot this formula, you get itself as its plot, but the cheat is this k down here, because I haven't actually specified where we are on the vertical y-axis. You can see on the x-axis we're 0 to 106, fairly normal territory, but here we're like k, what on earth is that? That k value is this number here. Basically, we are a long way up the y-axis right now. If you go a huge distance up the y-axis of this plot and you ignore everything else below it, and there's more after it, ignore everything above it, at this one particular zone between this number and this number plus 17 is where you get the equation that we were using to plot them. What's actually amazing about Tupper's self-referential formula is not that it plots itself, it's that it plots everything. As you go up the y-axis, it plots every single 106 by 17 grid of white and black pixels. So anything that fits in that grid is somewhere on this plot. So not only is Tupper's formula in the plot, but also every other formula you can fit into that size. In fact, I found a different value of k, which is where it's the same formula, but smiley faces instead of the word mod. And so that's a slightly different value of k, gives you the smiley face version of this formula. I've also found the point where Pac-Man is eating the formula as chased by a ghost. And so that one is, I think that one's going to be higher up as well. It's, yes, it's not far off though. And so anything you can possibly fit into one of these appears in there somewhere. And I can actually show you how you can get from any picture you want to that number. The way it actually works is you take the pixelated form of your equation. So let's get our original one. Let's do, where's the proper one? None of these ridiculous ones. Okay, here we go. Right, so there's the original one. And what you do is you start in the bottom left-hand corner, and if you want that to be a black pixel, you put a 1. And then you go to the one above it, and that's black as well, so we put another 1. And then the one above that is white, so we put a 0. One above that is white. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. 0, is that 2 or 3? Looks like 3, 0, 1, 0. And then you carry on and you scroll up the first column and then up the second column and up the next one and you write it off as a binary number. And you end up at the very end with a very long binary number. Yep. You then put that into base 10, you multiply it by 17, and that gives you the k value for where that plot appears on the graph. In fact, this is a bitmap function. And what Jeff Tupper was doing was looking at using equations and being able to plot them automatically using software. He's a computer scientist at University of Toronto. And this is a kind of a side effect. It's an interesting outcome of the legitimate proper research he was doing. In fact, Brady, I got you a present. I took the number file logo, pixelated it, turned it into a binary number, multiplied it by 17, put it into base 10, and there it is down there. So that is the k coordinate of the number file logo on Tupper's plot. Okay, so when I wrote my book, Things to Make and Do in the Fourth Dimension, I happened to have it with me at all times, as you know, Brady. I wanted to put in Tupper's self-referential formula, and so in the book, here it is. In the chapter on functions, I put in a picture of it, and I'm all like, oh wow, that's amazing. And then later on in the book, when I get to digital images, because it is just a bitmap, where is it? Here we go. I've got it again, and I explain the system. So there's the actual plot. There's if you turn it into zeros and ones, and there's when you multiply it by 17. Except that's not actually the correct number. So the plot's correct, the binary number's correct, but this is not, because I thought it would be hilarious to put in a different number. And so if anyone ever does take that number, and I've never told anyone, Penguin don't know this, FSG, who published it in the US, don't know this, I've not revealed it to anyone. It's the first public release of this information. If you reverse that number, you get a different plot. I have defaced the plot for that number. This is the world's slowest, longest running troll you will ever come across. So hopefully, you know, years from now, someone may finally get around to doing it and they will not be faced with that plot.